Hello viewers, this is Achilles again. Today I will be showing loadouts PvP, PvE for fire. Okay, first I'll start off with showing my stats. Okay, the way my buildup is, when I'm in PvP, I'm more a survivability, stay on one person till he's dead kind of person. The way it's set up is I'm based off of HP and just pure attack. When I usually fight people, I usually do like 170 hits to high, and then also I'm using brawling now. What I know about brawling, even though it's a lot slower than MA, you'll get somebody a lot up down a lot faster than you will with MA. Only good thing about MA is the shuriken spam. And once somebody gets through that, if I just lunge spamming you, then you're done. Also, my loadout. The way my loadout is set up is, I have two heal moves, two shields, and an AoE to pull in so that people won't get away. My supercharged healing. The way my loadout is, if I have full supercharge and a pot also, I will die in arena, even if there's not a healer, even if I have five people on me. The only time I usually die is if I'm in an 8v8, 2v2, I mean 5v5s, 4v4s, I won't die. It's very difficult to kill. Okay. Well, whenever I get jumped by a group of people, the first thing I always start off with is my light shield. Just so I can take that extra damage. And then I pop my health is like 75%, I'll pop that. And then whenever I try to like pull people off of like a group of my teammates or get somebody flying, I use this my pull move, AoE pull move. No matter if they're in the air or anything or anywhere around me, I'll automatically grab them in. And last but not least, I got the heal move where the next three hits will heal you. And basically, I live about 2 minutes off of just those, just by using those. And then, if my health starts to get low, that's when I'll use my supercharge. But before I even think about using my supercharge, I'll always pop this off and wait for my cooldowns. Simple fact that I'm waiting for my cooldowns and I'm waiting for my healer to come back. But if I don't have a healer, that's when the supercharge comes into place. And basically what I'll do is, I won't use it all the way full. I'll always wait till my health gets about like 10% or 10% just, and then I'll pop it off instantly, just in case there's a sword there to execute me. And I use like every time I use a supercharge, I only use it like once, and then I'll pop my pot. Now, if my health gets low again, then I use my supercharge again. But by that time, all my stuff is on cooldown, and my power goes up extremely fast. Also, I'll show you my power loadout. My power loadout, I'm completely on the right side. I don't use meter strike because it's useless, and the range, I'm always a range pick for my parts, and they QQ a lot when I use it line of sight. And I don't use consume objects because, to be honest, it's kind of weak, and it wouldn't fit anywhere on my bar. It's not for me. And my ignition. I'm completely on the left side, also on this. The problem that I hate about this tree is I had to use this skill point in order to get down here. If I didn't use the skill point, I went to my iconic powers, and now they got more power, just so I can keep on using my rotation. But yeah, the way my setup is, I'm based off of HP, toughness, 3% crit, because critical attack damage, it really isn't nothing. Say if you hit like say if you hit like 30, that extra 10% one is gonna give you 3 more attack. And yeah, I just got the 2 shields. Also, I'll show you my skill points. What I'm expecting to is brawling. Oh yeah, I forgot I had to respect because I just switched weapons. So basically, I will be taking all of these and this, and also I'm expecting the dual pistols too for the toughness and the damage. See, hold on, I'm gonna offer me explain. See, I'm expecting the only attack damage buffs. Anything to deal with mites, I'm not expecting to. It's affecting dual mode too. And I gotta go with dominance because you're supposed to have at least 100 dominance. Okay, and yeah, I gotta get rid of these right here. So yeah, that'll be like extra 3 more points for me right there. And also expecting a rifle. Extra more attack. Staff 2, toughness, dominance, and more attack. 2-handed, and more attack. Acrobatics, I expect completely on the right side of the tree just for the extra power boost whenever I can knock down anything. Also, okay, the way my gear is set up, I'm full tank. I'm full tanker just for the power and survivability. The way, since I have so many skill points, I can make up for you as a tanker. I have enough damage to kill you, like I'm in normal the normal PvP gear, not the tank gear. Also, my trinket too. The only thing I have to do is I have to get my pants. That's the last thing I'm looking for. Cause I did have a DPS set first, but now I'm going for a 10 PvP set. Cause I noticed the difference in power and everything. Also, versus ice, that's another reason why I got tank gear. Cause the way I fight ice is, you gotta have more power. When they run out of power, ice is trash. Just kill them like that. Now I'll show you what I do in PvE. Okay, now for the PvE setup. Let me switch my gear. Oh yeah, I gotta expect this guy. Give me a second. Okay, my power setup for this, I go mostly in the emulation. Really don't have to worry about power and PvP, get more power and PvP because we got controllers. And also in PvE, wildfire is actually useful. Some effect to keep up the diet and keep up the aggro. And also, I totally forgot. Sorry about that. Because I got extra points. That was my highlight shit. Skill points. I spec on the staff, but to me, it seemed like staff. Okay. game, I would still spec them. I normally just get in flame, just so I can just, that's when I just throw that AoE dot around, and I just spam wildfire. I just spam those two constantly, and I throw in this every once in a while just to pull it out. This really works in the outer back cave to down the final boss in less than, I'll say, a minute. Because I just pull on all the mobs, and then my whole attack can just AoE. Show you my stats. Yeah, I have 31 health. Almost forgot. Tank. I have about 530 dominance, 3.1k health, 2.5k defense, and that's all about what you need for tanking any raid so far in this game. And I don't die in a raid. I don't die in a raid unless something stupid happens. Like, let's say everybody in the raid dies and I have like not a supercharge left or anything. That's when I would die. But yeah, thanks for watching. If you got any questions, feel free to comment. Please subscribe. Have a nice day.